Emotional testimony as David Camm's attorneys try to convince the jury he didn't kill his wife and kids 13 years ago. It's the state's third effort to convict Camm after two overturned verdicts. This time, the trial is in Lebanon, northwest of Indianapolis. WLKY's Marissa Alter is live with from the Boone County Courthouse there with a wrap-up of the witnesses today. Marissa?
Rick, first on the stand today was Tom Jolly, someone who has been a key witness for this defense in the past two trials. He testified David Camm never left the church gym the night of the murders, even when he sat out of one of the basketball games. Jolly told the court during that time, Camm sat and talked to him before excusing himself and starting to stretch and run to return to the game. This is where David Camm maintains he was September 28, 2000, playing basketball at Georgetown Community Church's gym. It was after that weekly Thursday night meetup. He says he returned home to find his wife Kim and kids Brad and Jill shot to death in the garage. Here's how Camm described the time since then in an exclusive interview with WLKY last year.
It's just been such a, as you said, a roller coaster. It's indescribable. It really has been.
Wednesday, Camm's uncle, Nelson Lockhart, took the stand. Lockhart was at his elderly father's place across the street from the Camm family home the night of the murders. He told the jury he was on the phone when Camm started banging on the door and screamed for him to come quick. My children are dead. Somebody's killed my kids, my family. Lockhart testified he ran into the garage and saw Brad and Kim lying on the ground, a pool of blood around their heads. Camm was bent over Brad attempting CPR. Lockhart recounted how Camm told him to check on Jill in the Bronco. He touched her, but she was cool and clammy. Lockhart told the court it was apparent all of them were dead. He said Camm responded, "Why did I go play basketball?" At one point, Lockhart remembered how Camm fell to the ground. On cross, the prosecution got Lockhart to admit Camm volunteered the basketball alibi. He wasn't asked it. The state also pointed out how Camm stopped trying to resuscitate Brad to get Lockhart, then continued CPR in Lockhart's presence, something they say is not typical.
There is no evidence. The facts and the evidence have always been irrelevant in this case.
And Lockhart choked up on the stand as he recalled how much his father loved Brad and Jill. His sister, Debbie Turvey, testified next, and she became crying. She began crying, rather, almost immediately. She actually lived next door to the Camm family and talked about how her daughter was best friends with Jill and Brad, how the three of them did everything together. That testimony led to many in the audience also needing tissues. Now, testimony continues here tomorrow morning, and the defense does expect to call their blood experts tomorrow. Reporting live in Lebanon, I'm Marissa Alter, WLKY News.